let's jump into FL Studio. And as you can see, we have five different windows that are very important in FL Studio. First one is the playlist. Then we have the piano roll. We have the channel rack. We have the mixer. And then we have the browser. The browser, you cannot change it from this side here. The browser will always be on the left side, but you can, excuse me, you can rearrange the playlist and you can rearrange these windows. So let's say that I want to have a playlist and a mixer side by side. In this case, one on the top and one on the bottom. And I could probably do the opposite. I could have something like this. Let's do this and put the playlist maybe on this side, like so, and have the channel rack here, like that, and maybe add, can I bring the channel rack? I don't think so, yeah. And maybe have the, having the piano roll on this side. I'm messing up my normal windows, but whatever. As you can see, we could have all these organized differently and have all the windows. But let's say that you have multiple desktops, multiple monitor setup, like I do have. I have two monitors, one on this side and one on the left side. And let's say that I want to bring this window to my left side. And if you can't see, but I cannot bring this window out of FL Studio. The way to do it, and even here, so if I try to bring this up to the top here, I can't. It always limits by this window here. So this canvas of FL Studio is what is limiting me to move the window. But there's a way to unlock this, and the way to do it is by detaching the window. And if I go here to the triangle and I use detached, you see that the window didn't change, so it's the same. It is, looks the same. But now, if I move this up, you see that now it's on top of everything. And now if I maximize this, it even goes outside of the normal FL Studio top bar here. So this is the way for you to have your windows to float them. And if I bring this out to the next window, you see that it disappeared. You probably cannot see it, but you have to take my word for it. You can move things around and you can have them. You can detach and undetach all of the windows. One issue that you might find when doing detachable windows is that sometimes, let's say that I have this one, but I know I want to select the piano roll. The piano roll will always be on the bottom. So that's the downside of this. Also, you have to de-detach or detach this, and then you can switch between them. But you have one that is not detached, like for instance, this one, and you have one that is detached. This will always stay on top of the other ones. And this also, it's a little bit harder when you are dealing with plugins. So let me put this right there and let me extend my mixer. You can do that also with plugins. So let's do addictive keys. And you see that my plugins are detached by default. And if I go here, you see detached. And now I can't go to the top. And if I detached, I can move them to the top. So the problem with this one is that sometimes you might lose focus on your project. So let's say that I'm here. If I hit play, in this case, it works. But in some cases, you might lose focus. You might hit play and it plays something inside of the plugin and not the play button here in FL Studio. So you might find sometimes that is inconvenient to have your plugins detached, but at the same time is one of the things that I like because I have two monitors. I like to have all my plugins, or I like to move my plugins around to have some space to work here and maybe change some of the configurations of the plugins and still be able to edit my project on the go. Not on the go, but in one window and have other stuff in the second window. The way to have all of your plugins detached by default is you go to Options, General Settings, and this here, there's an option that says Detach All Plugins. And I have this set up because, again, I told you that I like to have all my plugins detachable or detached in when I load them. But if I remove this one, and if I now load a plugin, the same plugin that I loaded before, you see that is not detached by default. So I have to manually detach it like so, so that I can move it around and change the window preferences. I don't know if that's the correct word, but yeah. So now let's undetach this. Let's close. And again, here I prefer to have this detached because if I need, I can, most of the time I'm okay with having them detached, but sometimes I might find some issues. And what I do, I just undetach or not detached, and it will work as I'm expecting to work. So this is the tip. It's good to know how to detach and undetach windows, because that if you have a dual monitor setup, that's really helpful because it will allow you to improve your performance and your pro efficiency in FL Studio or any other DAW or any other software for that matter. And because you have more real estate to move things around, that you might be able to have in one window your FL Studio DAW, and for instance in the next window you might have the playlist and the mixer all together, and you still have time or enough space to have it the other window to have more stuff. So that's why I like to have this dual setup, dual monitor setup, and that's why I like to use this detached property to move things around.